Welcome back, friends. It's so good to see you today. If you brought your Bible, can you hold it up? Wonderful. Can anyone tell me what the Bible is about? That's right. The Bible is God's word. It tells us the wonderful story of God's plan to rescue sinners. The Bible tells us what is true about God and about ourselves. Today, we will see how God works in our lives through easy times and hard times for his glory and our good.
Now, who remembers our big picture question? Why don't we say our big picture question and answer together? Ready? Who is in control of everything? God is in control of everything in heaven and on earth. Nothing is outside of God's good plan. Yay, good job. Friends, this truth is comforting because no matter what happens, nothing surprises God. Nothing is outside of God's good plan. We may be caught off guard by unexpected events, but God already knows. He is in control and we can trust him. Keep that in mind when you hear today's story.
We've been hearing about God's solution for sin, which he promised in Eden. God's plan became clearer when God made a covenant with Abraham. He promised to bring the rescuer through Abraham's family. Abraham's family struggled with challenges and consequences of sin. Through it all, God was faithful. Nothing could stop his plan. Last time we saw that God changed Jacob. He made Jacob's name Israel. Jacob's future family would form the nation of Israel, and the people would be called Israelites. Jacob's family grew through his sons. There are 12 sons, and out of all of his sons, Jacob loved Joseph the most.
Excuse me. Well, what? There were 12 sons?
Mm-hmm.
Whoa.
Okay. So let me see if I can get this correct. So Jacob had 12 sons. Yeah. And Joseph was his favorite. Mm-hmm. Jacob's other sons hated Joseph. One day, Jacob sent Joseph to check on his brothers, who were tending to the sheep. The brothers saw Joseph coming, and they made a plan to get rid of him.
No, that's not good. What did they do, Miss Chloe?
The brothers sold Joseph as a servant to some travelers going to Egypt.
Oh, no. Wait. What did Joseph's dad and mom say?
Well, the brothers convinced Jacob that wild animals had killed his favorite son. So Jacob was very sad. Meanwhile, those travelers that had bought Joseph, well, they sold him to an Egyptian officer named Potiphar.
I'm not sure I can handle any more of this story. What comes next?
Well, remember that the Lord was with Joseph. In fact, the Lord made Joseph successful at everything he did, even as a servant. Potiphar put Joseph in charge of many things, and Potiphar was really happy with him.
Well, that's great. So there's a happy ending then, right?
Well, Potiphar's wife lied about Joseph, accusing him of doing something that he didn't do. This made Potiphar very angry, and he put Joseph in prison.
Now Joseph is in prison? Oh, no.
Remember, God was still with Joseph and blessed him, even while Joseph was in prison, Miss Laura. God gave Joseph the ability to understand the meaning of dreams. Years passed, and Joseph was forgotten in prison until Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, had two dreams. So he sent for Joseph, and Joseph explained the dreams. Egypt was going to have 7 good years with plenty of food, followed by 7 bad years of no food. Joseph told Pharaoh to save food during the good years to use during the bad years. So Pharaoh realized that God was with Joseph. So, do you know what he did? He made Joseph second in command in all of Egypt. Joseph stored away food during the good years. And then, during the famine, people came to him to buy grain.
Now that's some good planning. God really did use Joseph. Hey, whatever happened to Joseph's brothers?
Well, one day, Jacob sent 10 of his sons, which were Joseph's brothers, and he sent them to Egypt to buy grain.
This is getting good. Did Joseph see them? What did he say? Did he finally apologize? I wish I could have been a fly on the wall back then to see their faces.
Those are all wonderful questions, Miss Laura. Let me answer them. The brothers came to Joseph and bowed down. Joseph knew who they were, but they didn't recognize him. When Joseph was ready, he told his brothers who he was. "I'm Joseph," he said. "Don't be afraid. God sent me here so I could save your people from the famine." Joseph's brothers went home to bring all their family and belongings back to Egypt. Jacob hugged his son Joseph, and they cried. Jacob's family was blessed in Egypt, but Jacob got older and died. Now Joseph's brothers were afraid Joseph would punish them for what they did to him in the past. But Joseph said, "You planned evil against me. God planned it for good to bring about the present result, the survival of many people." Joseph comforted his brothers and spoke kindly to them.
I love all of these stories about Joseph. There are so many great lessons here, and we see God and his faithfulness all throughout. Let's recap this story so we can make sure that we understand it all, okay? Joseph was 17 years old when his brothers sold him to travelers going to Egypt. He was in Egypt for 20 years before he saw them again. During that time, Joseph was falsely accused of wrongdoing and thrown into prison. Well, why did Pharaoh later put him in position of power? Let's look in our Bibles. Pull your Bible out for me, and let's look in Genesis chapter 41, verses 37 through 40. That is the big 41 and the little 37. Hey, is Genesis in the beginning or the end of the Bible? That's right. Genesis is in the beginning. All right. Chapter 41. This proposal pleased Pharaoh and his servants. And Pharaoh said to his servants, "Can we find a man like this in whom is the Spirit of God?" And Pharaoh said to Joseph, "Since God has shown you all this, there is none so discerning and wise as you are. You shall be over my house, and all my people shall order themselves as you command. Only as regard to the throne will I be greater than you."
Whoa, God was with Joseph. God gave Joseph the ability to interpret dreams, and he made Joseph wise. When there was a famine, Joseph was in charge of the food in Egypt. How did God use Joseph's position for good? Well, let's look at Genesis chapter 42, verse 6. It says, "Now Joseph was governor over the land. He was the one who sold to all the people of the land, and Joseph's brothers came and bowed themselves before him with their faces to the ground." Joseph's brothers came to Egypt for food. Without his help, their family would have probably starved. But God also used the famine to bring Joseph's family back together. Joseph believed that God was in control and working out his plan to rescue his people, even through the actions of Joseph's brothers. Joseph didn't realize all God was doing while it was happening, but he was able to look back and see God provided a way for his family to thrive in Egypt. Had Joseph's brothers not done evil, Joseph would have not been in Egypt. Had Potiphar's wife not lied, Joseph would have not been in prison. And had Joseph not been in prison, Pharaoh's servants would have not met him. And had Pharaoh's servants not met him, Joseph wouldn't have been introduced to Pharaoh, who put him in charge of Egypt.
Wow, what Joseph's brothers intended for harm, God intended for good. Joseph invited his family to come live in Egypt where they could thrive. God clearly used Joseph to provide for Jacob's family and establish a remnant. As Jacob made his way to Egypt, God spoke to him in a vision and repeated the promise he first made to Abraham. Friends, let's look at one last verse, Genesis chapter 46, verse 3. Ready? Verse 3, "Then he said, I am God, the God of your father. Do not be afraid to go down to Egypt, for there I will make you into a great nation. Wow, God had a plan for Joseph's life. He allowed Joseph to suffer in order to rescue a whole nation. Does this sound familiar? God planned for Jesus to suffer so that many people from all nations, many would be saved. Jesus died on the cross to save people from their sins.
When we hear Joseph's story, we don't think about how great Joseph was. We think about how great God is. God was working to bring about good from evil. That brings us right back to our big picture question and answer. Who is in control of everything? God. God is in control of everything in heaven and on earth. Nothing is outside of God's good plan. Friends, before we say goodbye for this week, will you please join us in prayer? Bow your heads with me. Lord God, thank you for your word. Lord, even when our circumstances are not good, we know you are always good. You are working in our lives for your glory and for our good. Lord, we love you. Amen. Friends, thank you so much for joining us today. We hope you have a fabulous week. Bye, everyone.